Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Martin Yanev, an aerospace engineer from Southampton, UK. And today we are going to talk about one issue that has been there for the last 13 years. And this is the problem of whether or not an aircraft can take off from a conveyor belt which moves in the opposite direction with the same speed. This problem was actually tested about a decade ago by Mythbusters, but they never gave a proper scientific explanation on why an aircraft can take off from a conveyor belt traveling in the opposite direction with the same speed. While I was studying my bachelor's degree in aerospace engineering, I had many arguments with different students about this. So my opinion is that an aircraft can take off from a conveyor belt traveling in the opposite direction with the same speed. However, many of my colleagues didn't think in the same way, so we had many times arguments about that. When I was a student, I was actually having this argument with one of my colleagues. I will not say his name, but let's call him Mr. Petanka. So Mr. Petanka, he was thinking that an aircraft cannot possibly take off from a conveyor belt traveling with the same speed but in the opposite direction. And I was thinking differently. So we went to our professor of aerodynamics and we asked him. And surprisingly for me, the aerodynamics professor, he supported my colleagues. So he thought that it is impossible an aircraft to take off from a conveyor belt. So watch this video until the end and I will prove you that it is perfectly possible an aircraft to take off from a conveyor belt traveling with the same speed but in the opposite direction. And not only perfectly possible, this will happen actually for sure. To understand this, we first need to know how an aircraft takes off and what an aircraft needs to actually take off from the runway. For aircraft to take off, you need it to move through a flow with high speed. When the speed of the flow around the aircraft is high, then the pressure of the lower surface of the wing is higher than the pressure of the upper surface of the wing. This creates suction, which generates lift, and once the lift is higher than the weight of the aircraft simply takes off. And the speed at which the standard aircraft are taking off is about 200 km per hour. So once the aircraft moves forward with 200 km per hour, it generates enough lift in order to overcome its weight and it takes off. It is that simple. And if a wind is blowing to the aircraft can take off with lower speed because the flow around the aircraft is the sum between the wind speed and the forward speed. So one last thing before starting with the actual experiment, let's just talk about what are all the forces around the aircraft. So the first force is the thrust force, which moves forward and is produced by the engines. The other one is the lift force, which is pointing up and actually makes the aircraft to take off or be lifted from the ground. The other one is the drag force, which is in the opposite direction of the thrust force. And the last force is the weight force, which is in the opposite direction of the lift force and is pointing to the ground. These are all the forces that the aircraft uses. First, let's talk about what would happen if an aircraft has stopped on a conveyor belt that is traveling in the opposite direction with 100 km per hour. Well, obviously in that case, the aircraft will move backwards. But what is going to be the speed? Is it going to be 100 kilometers or is it going to be a different speed? Well, I would say it depends. It depends because the speed from the conveyor belt is transmitted to the aircraft by the wheels. So how much speed from the conveyor belt is transmitted to the aircraft pretty much depends on the rolling friction of the wheels. So let's imagine that our wheels, instead of circular, are square. In that case, we will have the maximum friction, so all the speed from the conveyor belt will be transmitted to the aircraft. On the other side, if we have no rolling friction on the wheels, this means that no speed will be transmitted from the conveyor belt to the aircraft, so the aircraft will stay static. And here comes the main difference between an aircraft and a car on a conveyor belt. In the car case, as the speed is coming always from the wheels and the wheels are not freely movable, this means that the friction there is going to always be 100%. And this is not the case with the aircraft. With the aircraft, as the wheels are moving freely, we will always have friction between 0 and 100. And this friction pretty much depends on how the wheels are built and how much weights the aircraft. The more the aircraft weights, the more friction we will have. So now we know that if the conveyor belt travels with 200 km per hour backwards, then the aircraft will not move backwards with the same speed. So if we apply 200 km per hour forward speed of the aircraft, it will still move forward, but definitely not with 200 km per hour. So let's imagine that the resultant speed from the conveyor belt is 190 km per hour, while the resultant forward speed is 200 km per hour. And when we deduct from the forward speed the backward speed, we are left only with 10 km per hour. Definitely not a speed that the aircraft can take off with, right? But here it comes the interesting part. Even if the aircraft is moving only with 10 km per hour forward, then a very small lift will be produced. And as the small lift is produced, the aircraft gets lighter. And as the aircraft gets lighter, the friction in the wheels reduces. And this process is going to happen over and over again until the speed of the aircraft reaches the maximum possible speed, which is 200 km per hour. So at some point, the conveyor belt will have no effect on the aircraft because the aircraft will become so light that it will simply move forward and take off. So it doesn't actually matter what is the rolling coefficient of the aircraft unless it's maximum. Only in the case that the rolling coefficient is maximum or the aircraft have square wheels, will not have takeoff from a conveyor belt. In any other case, when the aircraft has a circular wheels, the friction coefficient will definitely not be maximum. So the aircraft will freely take off from the conveyor belt. So I'm really happy that after 13 years, this is finally solved. So Mr. Petanka, it's over. Guys, thank you very much for watching. Please write me down in the comments if you agree with me or you think that I missed something. If you value the content that I'm sharing with you, please give a like to that video or subscribe my channel. This really motivates me to create content like this and find answers to the aerospace questions you have. But if you cannot wait until my next video, well, you can start with these ones.